Tushar Pandey. She is an independent consultant, PPP, Agriculture and Social Equity.
Thank you, Chair. Thank you, IFPRI, for inviting me and FAO for this prestigious conference. Maybe I'll exceed for half a minute since the Chair has mentioned there is some time. Just to set the background, in my personal capacity, I have spent most of my time with the private sector, banking industry, financial institutions, but I have been completely focusing, working with the government affairs and government policies. Even as I speak completely with the private sector hat, but I do speak in a capacity where I got a chance to work with several governments, my own country government, my country state governments, India, as well as international governments, including CGIAR. Before saying, if you just spend about a minute on the fundamental, the fact is public-private partnership in a contractual sense is a very, very serious subject. It has been understood perhaps in that sense a little bit better in other sectors such as transportation, roads, and I'm not really commenting on the efficiency and all. There are debates on, you know, how much successful it has been, but the fact is that you know, the veracity by which those fundamentals have been studied, you know, are there. But in agriculture, we somewhere, you know, just have anybody public, anybody private, and we say that. So therefore, having said that, look at risk-reward mechanism structures. Private sector is inherently a commercial entity. And therefore, let us keep one thing in mind. Profit is not a bad word. You know, exploitation is a bad word, you know. Over-exploitation, doing unlawful things is a bad word, but profit is not a bad word. So therefore, if private sector is coming, you know, and Cheng and Fan mentioned it yesterday, you know, private sector is your friend, he's not really your enemy. Therefore, when private sector is coming in, you are a public body, you know, I'm just wearing a policy hat because, you know, we are interested in nutrition today and, you know, we want to see how it benefits. And therefore, if he is coming in, you know, he is going to be looking at profitability. You need not tell him, you know, always what is your profitability. He is smart enough to understand and devise his own mechanism. So part of your problem can actually be addressed by how a particular private sector attaches itself to the scenario. And private sector attachment could be varied. You know, some private sector may not come to you initially and they may say that, okay, they may come at a later stage. The second part of the thing is that some of the public-private partnership solutions which come out, they are necessarily not in the ambit of, you know, nutrition as an umbrella or agriculture as an umbrella. You know, they may be, some of these solutions may lie outside the ambit, but you need to continuously evolve your particular structures. For example, you know, you are working with community structures, you know, Campina just mentioned they are cooperatives, you know, they are cooperatives by their original statute, but they are corporates by expansion, you know, when they are expanding. So therefore, you know, you need as a policy, how do you set up these community structures? How do you come forward and bring out, you know, so that social equity is placed in and the farmer becomes owner. And therefore, when you are placing community structures, please remember that the community in itself may not be entrepreneurial. So you have to find out those entrepreneurial sparks. So when we worked in the banking sector, we were always, you know, concerned with the fact that where is the commercial viability at the end? And we looked at, you know, expansion for the microfinance sector, how does it go forward? So last, my point is that there is a scale down challenge problem involved. You know, sometimes when you speak up and for smaller communities, you know, you need to agglomerate institutional structures, land pooling, for example, you know, converting you know, your subsidy model, grant model into a viability gap mechanism so that, you know, any private sector which comes in, your policy can cascade. If one private sector is not coming in one region, how can it go into some other regions? I had many more things to say, but I guess I'll stop for now and probably have a chance to come on some of the points, you know, once we are in the discussion mode. Thank you very much.
Thank you.